girl, tell me only this, that I have your heart for always, and you want me by your side, whispering the words I'll always love. I'll give you all the joy my heart and soul can give. Let me hold you. I need to have you near me. And I feel with you in my arms. Love.
Who gives this woman in marriage? Thank you. On behalf of Scott and Corey, I'd like to welcome all of you to this happy occasion. I'm going to ask that we take just a moment to go inside of ourselves, let go of some of the anxiety and the excitement that I'm sure some of us have had today, and find that place inside that is calm and comfortable and happy and loving and all the good things in our life. And let us bring forth some of that love and happiness that we might be able to share with Scott and Corey at this moment of happiness in their life. So whatever way you find works best for you, let us all begin by observing a moment of silence. Thank you. We are gathered here in this beautiful, quaint old house on this happy occasion to witness and to celebrate the coming together of two separate lives. We have come to join Scott and Corey in marriage, to be with them and to rejoice with them in the making of this all-important commitment. Scott and Corey, the essence of this commitment is the taking of another person in his or her entirety as lover, companion, and friend. It is therefore a decision not to be made lightly, but rather undertaken with great consideration and respect, both for oneself and the other person. Love is one of the highest experiences that we human beings can have. It can add depth of meaning to our lives. The sensual part of love is one of life's greatest joys. When this is combined with real friendship, both are infinitely enhanced. The day-to-day companionship, the pleasure in doing things together or in doing separate things and rejoicing to exchange experiences once we come back together, is a continuous and central part of what a man and a woman who love each other can share. Marriage symbolizes the intimate sharing of two lives. Yet this sharing must not diminish but enhance the individuality of each partner. A marriage that lasts is one that continues to develop and in which each person continues to grow in deeper understanding of the other. Deep knowledge of another is not something that can be attained in a short time. Real understanding can only come with years of intimacy. This wonderful knowledge of another person grows out of really caring so much. One wants to understand as completely as possible just what the other is feeling. And thus it is possible to share not only joys and successes, but also the burden of sorrow and failure. To be known in this way is a priceless thing. Such understanding and acceptance makes it easier to live together in peace and in happiness. So while marriage is the coming together of two separate lives, it can yet enhance the differences and the individuality of each partner. We must give of ourselves in love, but we must not give ourselves away. A good and balanced relationship is one in which neither partner is overshadowed or absorbed by the other. And thus it is out of the tension between separateness and union that love, whose incredible strength equal only to its own incredible fragility, is born and reborn. We are here then tonight to celebrate that love that you two have for each other and to give social recognition to your mutual decision to accept each other into the state of matrimony. Would you hold it up? Want to turn and face each other and hold hands. We will repeat the vow, starting with Scott. Corey, I take you as my wife.
Corey, I take you as my wife.
I pledge to share my life.
I pledge to share my life.
Openly with you.
Openly with you.
To speak the truth.
To speak the truth.
To you in love.
To you in love.
I promise to honor.
I promise to honor.
And tenderly care for you.
And tenderly care for you.
To cherish and encourage.
To cherish and encourage.
Your own fulfillment.
Your own fulfillment.
As an individual.
As an individual. individual.
Through all the changes of our lives.
Through all the changes of our lives.
Now, Corey, God, I take you as my husband.
God, I take you as my husband.
I pledge to share my life.
I pledge to share my life.
Openly with you.
Openly with you.
To speak the truth.
To speak the truth.
To you in love.
To you in love.
I promise to honor.
I promise to honor.
And tenderly care for you.
And tenderly care for you.
To cherish and encourage.
To cherish and encourage.
Your own fulfillment.
Your own fulfillment.
As an individual.
Individual.
Through all the changes of our lives.
Through all the changes of our lives.
And what symbol do we have of this union? Thank you. We have these two wedding rings, which are a traditional symbol of marriage, a perfect circle. Without beginning or end, they symbolize true love, and that true love has no beginning, no end. Even though each of you may have thought that you discovered love or fell in love at a certain time, it existed long before that moment, and it will exist long after this moment, where we here gathered bear witness to it through this ceremony. As you wear the rings, be reminded of that love that unites you, spirit to spirit, heart to heart, and life to life. Also, I'd ask that you be reminded of that special gift, that gift of yourself, that each of you gives to the other throughout all the time of your togetherness, just as you give these rings now. And as you take the ring, placing it upon your partner's finger, you may wish to share with your partner just what it symbolizes for you or any other words of endearment. Left hand. Left hand. There we go. Okay. That's good. Put on. Scott and Corey as a witness, and that's all that I can be, for truly you two marry each other. It is your covenant of love, your commitment and dedication to this relationship that I witness. I witness for the state, the community, your friends here gathered, those friends who couldn't be here, for the Almighty and Universal God, that you have this day married each other. And I ask God's blessing on your union, that it may be a long-lasting, loving, happy, wonderful relationship. God bless you both. I'm gonna kiss now. Sign right there. Okay. Now, you may sign your last name as Richardson or Rich, whichever you're going to use from now on. Okay, I'll give you a couple more so you can play.
How are you doing this? I'm just making one good.
All right, one more.
Mandy was too cool.
She was.
Oh, we got three on side. She did perfect. Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you. song that I wrote especially for this wedding and for these two. And the song is called Gathering My Love, and I wrote it as if I were getting married, which is true. But I'm going to try my best to do this song because I just memorized the words not even a week ago. So if I forget, forgive me.
Congratulations on your marriage. Hope you have many good years, and hopefully everything will work out real well for you.
Corey, we're glad to have you for a daughter-in-law, and I know you guys are going to do really good.
Corey and Scott, we wish you all the luck in the world. Wish you all the happiness that can go with a married life.
I go for that myself. So it's been nice being here all week, and we've had a nice time with our son and his wife. And we'll come back again.
Do
Congratulations, Corey and Scott. We're very glad we could be at your wedding tonight. Hope you have a happy life from now on.
I'd like to thank everybody for all the help they've given me in putting this together, and I'd like to wish the bride and groom the best.
That's it? Oh, okay. My turn? Ah, okay. I'd like to thank everyone also, and in all the confusion, I think today we forgot to tell Corey that my sister Donna called from Ohio, and so they all send their best. Thanks again for everyone.
Well, I've seen you guys together, and I know that you can have a real good life together. I just hope you guys keep an open mind with each other and grow instead of not smother each other, but grow with each other.
Well,
for it to work, I'm sure you guys are going to need to communicate. You're both going to have to work with each other. And I knew it all along when you guys started out. It was going to work, and may God bless you.
You make a great couple anyway.
Well, Corey and Scott, we wish you both the best. We want you to try to have patience with each other and talk to each other. And I think you already know that if you need anything, that you can depend on us if we can do it, whatever we can do for you.
I agree with him. Anything you need.
Corey, such a nice day. Come to your wedding. I remember your little birthdays and everything, and we love you, and I wish you all the best, sweetie pie.
Corey's always been our precious doll. And I hope Scott always treats her as such. And I hope they have a long, happy life.
Scott and Corey, we wish you the very best in your new marriage. This has been a very enjoyable evening, and everything went well, and you both were beautiful. The ceremony was very special. May you both be very happy.
I think that says it all.
Oh, hey, Scott, you and Corey, we want to wish you all the happiness in the world and hope you have a real happy marriage like we have and many, many good years ahead for you. Your turn.
Am I supposed to say something?
Sure.
Corey, I think you have a wonderful wedding, and you should be proud of your parents that took so much time with you and everything. And you and Scott have a happy wedding.
Corey, I love you, and we're going to last forever. We're going to live our lives, and it's going to be beautiful.
Well, Scott, I love you too. We're going to have long, happy marriage and lots of kids. No, one kid. And have a good old time.
I love you.
I love you too.
You mean more to me than words. Yeah.